Hi folks, today I'm going to show you how to create a multi-step form in HubSpot. Now, whether you're using HubSpot as a landing page and want to take your form game to the next level, or if you're using another website builder and just want to send leads to HubSpot, this video has you covered. HubSpot is a brilliant tool. We use it ourselves for our CRM and can't recommend it enough. HubSpot lets you create basic forms and collect details like email address and name, but it's all pretty simple. There's no option to add multiple steps, no progress bars, and the types of fields you can add are kinda limited. So HubSpot doesn't let you create multi-step forms out of the box, but there are a few workarounds and techniques that you can use to get a beautiful, high-performing form on your HubSpot site. Let's get into it. Okay, so workarounds, and one you can start with is to create a form with, say, one or two questions on it, and then set the thank you page to the address of another form. It's basic, but you've effectively created a multi-step form. You can use this same technique with landing pages too, just enter the URL that the form is embedded on, rather than the form itself. Another workaround is to use HubSpot's logic feature to show more fields as the user progresses. Here, under the dependent field section, for example, you could set the last name to show, but only when the first name is populated. But again, this isn't really a multi-step form, it just sort of replicates the feel of one, which isn't what we're after. In my opinion, the best way to create a multi-step form on HubSpot is to use a specialist multi-step form builder like Growform. You can create a high-quality, responsive form that looks something like this in only a few clicks, and crucially, send the leads right to HubSpot. A form like this is way more powerful than out-of-the-box HubSpot forms and gives you powerful conditional logic, progress bars, best practice templates, and so much more. Let me show you how it all works. All right, so Growform is the solution here, but how do we get this all up and running? Well, first you'll want to sign up at growform.co, and they do offer a 14-day free trial, which is always a welcome incentive for trying out something new. Once you have created an account and logged in, you will be directed to the Growform dashboard. Now, here, hit create new form, choose a template that suits you. We're gonna go for none, start with a blank slate, and I'm going to call this my HubSpot form because I'm very original. Next, you'll want to delete any fields that don't make sense and edit the form for your needs. I've already gone ahead and done this. It's really easy, very intuitive. So here, for example, select a field by clicking it. You can delete a field by hitting the delete or the trash can icon for our American friends out there. You can add a field by choosing one from the left-hand side. Edit the field by clicking it, giving it a name, edit all of the settings on the left. Nice and simple. We've now got something that resembles a form, but let's make it a nice shade of HubSpot orange. Gotta stay on brand. Nice and easy to do this. Hit theme in the right, which opens up the theme settings, and go wild. Got a lovely shade of orange here. No matter what your brand guidelines are, I'm confident you'll be able to come up with a form that looks great and will fit in anywhere. And also your marketing manager will be pleased that you chose the right color palette. Anyway, if you wish to add and edit more steps, you can easily do so by using the step navigation dropdown in the top left corner. And look, I know this is going to sound obvious, but please remember to click save once you've done building. You will be stunned at how many people close tabs and browsers and expect everything to still be there at a later date. Save your work, people. Okay, so we've got our form, we've created it, and now we need to embed it in our website. The easiest way is to just link to the form. You can do this by going to Share Form in Growform, it's right at the top, and then copying the link that's at the bottom of the page. You can add a link to the form anywhere on your website, for example, on a button or link. But let's say you want to see the form inside your landing page, presented alongside the other content. How do we do that? Well, first, you'll need to create a custom HubSpot module. Before you begin panicking, this is much easier than it sounds. Just follow these steps. So to create a custom module in HubSpot, go to Content on the left, and then click Design Manager, hit File, followed by New File, open the options you can see, and select Module. Click Next. You'll now see a bunch of options where you can add this, and here we're going to click Landing Pages and Site Pages. You can also select Global Module here so that when we update the module's content, it updates everywhere. Give it a name and then hit Create. You've now got a brand new area where you can add some content. So now we head over to Growform and under the Share Form tab that we were at previously, copy the code under Embed Growform directly onto your website with an HTML snippet. Once you've copied it, head back to HubSpot, paste this into the module.html box and hit Publish Changes on the right. So we've now created our module and we can use this anywhere we like, but we will have to find it. This is where you can give the module a label, hit publish again before we head to the landing page to add this module. Once you're on the landing page, click the plus or the add button, search for the module you've just made. For me, I'm searching Growform. There it is. Click and drag it over and now you've got the form on your page. Hit preview. It's in the top right, and you'll see we can now interact with our form. Job done. If indeed you are using another landing page builder other than HubSpot, such as WordPress, Unbounce, Webflow, or Squarespace, the process is very simple. To find the relevant guide, all you have to do is just go back to Share Form and then click Your Landing Page Builder at the top. So now we've created our form, we need to actually send the leads that we get through to HubSpot, as right now, the leads are just going to stay in Growform. The first thing to do is fire off a test. This will help us to map the fields in just a few moments. So I'm back in the preview off my landing page, and I'm going to fill in my own details here as a test. So I'm with HubSpot, my landing page is Canva, hit next. My name's Colin, and this is the email address of my Gaelic metalcore band, hence the guitars. And now, as we can see by visiting the View Leads page in Growform, the lead has been collected. Booyah. So let's go ahead and send the leads to HubSpot via Zapier, which I always thought was called Zapier, like Edinburgh Napier. But hey, you learn something new every day. If you're also new to this, Zapier is an integrations platform, sort of like a glue between tools like Growform and HubSpot. So go ahead and sign up for an account on Zapier if you don't have one already, and then hit Create in the top left to get started. From there, you want to click Zaps, and then inside Trigger, you can search Growform. Under Event, choose New Form Submission, and then you need to link your Growform account, which I can do right here. You'll need to find your API key, which as Zapier explains, is under your account. Once you have it, press continue, and then let's find the form we've created, which as you can see, is already there under my HubSpot form. Press continue again, and then at this point, Zapier will search for our recent form submissions, and because we've already created one, we can hit test trigger. And voila, it will find our submission from my Gaelic metalcore band. Success. If you were yet to create a test submission, then go ahead and do that, and then come back to this step. For me, this all looks good, so we will continue with the selected record. As you can see, we are now on the action step. So search for HubSpot, and under the events label, we'll find create contact. Before hitting continue, connecting our HubSpot in the process, and then continuing once again. Now, the most important information here is going to be the email address. So let's search for that field at the top, and inside that field, you can add your email address, which shows me the one I've just tested. Go through these fields, and of course, map any HubSpot fields to any relevant Growform fields that you've collected, and hit continue. We're now going to hit test step, and after a few seconds, Zapier will tell me that this contact was successfully sent to HubSpot. Now I'm ready to save our Zap and to ensure it's all working as it's meant to, if we go back to HubSpot and check our contacts, we'll be able to see that Gunghul Music has indeed been successfully created in the account. Job well and truly done. Well, that does bring me to the end of this guide, and with it, I trust you have learned yourself how to create a beautiful multi-step form that sends leads straight to HubSpot. To take things even further, you can consider adding more steps to your form, adding some conditional logic, or even adjusting theme settings further to really make it your own. If you found this video useful, do let me know in the comments. I always appreciate hearing any feedback that you have. And of course, you are most welcome to like and subscribe if these kinds of videos are exactly what you or your business needs. Have fun out there, and I will see you again very soon.